Washington right here in Times Square. Going to get a little sneak peek of season 3 of Scandal is on tonight.
Oh, well, those two especially very excited.
The whole crowd loves it. And just one look, and you don't need me to tell you, she was named People's Best Dressed Woman in the World. She's now sharing some of her style secrets with everybody. Is walk by the windows of Saks Fifth Avenue here in New York. You see the whole place is decked out in scandalous, if you will, style. By Kerry Washington herself.
I do believe that's Tori Burch.
If I'm not mistaken.
Did you just fashion check?
Lightning strikes once, everybody.
Wow. So happy to have you here, Kerry. And then also Marie Osmond is joining us, spilling all about her new passion project. So we'll get into that.
Yeah, that's nice having her here. So why don't we get to it? Because it's been a long 5 months for fans of ABC's smash hit Scandal. The wait is finally over. Season 3 premieres tonight. And this morning, Ms. Washington is here with us. We saw you, Olivia Pope. You're in the back of the limo.
Yeah.
This character that we have been seeing all season long and didn't know he was your father.
I know.
You were as shocked as everybody else.
Yeah, I had no idea. Joe Morton, the actor who plays my dad, he knew. But I had no idea. When I got the script for the season finale, I turned to the very last page of the script and I saw those three letters, D-A-D. I thought, are you kidding me? This is my father? So that is exactly where we start the season premiere, is in that car with my dad and I, and we pick up moments after the finale.
That's exactly it. Yeah. So let's play a little bit, because it's just moments after, and you're back there in your office, and you've already been discovered to be the mistress of the president.
Some would call her that.
Okay.
Some might call her the love of his life.
That's true. Season 3.
What should we do? What's our first move? We do nothing. It's being handled, which means all of you can go back to work. Business as usual.
Business as usual? How's that even possible?
You pick up the phone and call our clients. Show them we're as dedicated to them as ever. What?
Are we really not going to talk about the fact that you're the most infamous woman in America?
The world.
In the world, right now.
It's being handled.
By who? The White House?
Now, some of your co-stars have been giving us back off, Lara Spencer. She is such a little groupie.
She's such an original gladiator,
Lara Spencer. But I know you can't give away too much, but it was interesting when you said that even you, in reading the script and knowing what Shonda Rhimes and company have in store, that you're going gasping as well.
Yeah, every week it's a roller coaster ride, and we all feel really lucky to be on this show. We feel like we have the most amazing writers, and they are not holding back. They are still going for it week after week, episode after episode. We are shocked by the things we are asked to do and by the storylines that our characters are living through. It's really inspiring.
Well, it's wonderful. You've been around for some time, and people just have always respected your work on the big screen and the little screen. And for you to say that you had reservations, here this role is humongous, nominated for an Emmy for it.
Yeah.
Why did you have reservations about playing?
You know, I had never really made this kind of commitment to television, and it's so much work. It's harder than I've ever worked before in my life to do 22 episodes of a full season, 17 hours a day. But it's so fulfilling because the writing is so good. And once I really read the script and I thought, oh my goodness, it's Shonda Rhimes, this character, this show, this world, how could I say no? And I'm so grateful that this opportunity has come my way.
It jumps off the screen. All the many things that you are involved in, and you're very philanthropic, and also you have been very giving in just of yourself. And People Magazine named you one of the most beautiful, best-dressed women in the world, and people have been screaming and asking you, and there's an important reason why you're wearing that particular dress.
Yes, this dress is designed by my dear friend Tori Burch, but I wore it also because it's pink, and I know here at GMA we're going pink for Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and my mother's a breast cancer survivor.
That seems so very much.
Yeah.
Just all the things that you are involved in and going forward, how do you come together as a cast? Because you said you saw each other last night.
Yeah, we were last night together at the Saks event because we have these beautiful windows in New York. That's all the fashion from Scandal. Mm-hmm. We got together over the weekend to watch the episode. We're very close. We really are like a family. I think it might be hard for people to imagine that, as much as we are frenemies on the show, trying to kill each other and rival each other for power, that in real life we just adore each other, all of us.
Well, it shows, and we are. We're, okay, Lara. if you want to come in, you can come in now.
be a Pope White.
I know.
Thank you for always being so generous.
I love that we get to share the ABC love.
Yeah. Season 3.
Tonight. 10-9 Central.
Tell me more. No. It's the final check of the weather with Sam. Thank you, Carrie.
I'm just strolling around behind you in the patch, enjoying the fall colors. Carrie, if you'll notice, just going for a walk in the fall leaves here in Times Square. Good morning, you guys. How are you? Nice to see you. Thank you for coming by. Thank you so much. Let's get to the boards because we've got to talk a little bit about a tropical storm.